This tutorial shows how to use comments in Google Docs. Hello, my name is Erin. I'm a technical writer and editor who shares easy-to-follow software tutorials and writing tips for the real world on this channel and on my blog at erinwrightwriting.com. Today we're going to look at how to use comments in Google Docs. Specifically, we'll look at four key tasks: how to insert comments, how to reply to comments, how to resolve comments, and how to delete comments. Google can decide to change the appearance of Google Docs at any time, so your interface might look slightly different than the interface shown here. There are six ways to insert a comment in Google Docs: from within the text, from the right margin, from the toolbar, from the Insert tab, from the comment history, and with a keyboard shortcut. We're going to walk through all six methods, but don't worry, it won't take very long at all. To insert a comment directly from within your text, select the text or an image, and then right-click and select Comment from the shortcut menu. Enter your comment into the text box and then select the comment button. The process for entering your comment and selecting the comment button will be the same for the remaining five methods, so we won't repeat it each time. The second way is to select text or an image and then select the comment button in the right margin. This button won't appear until text or an image is selected. The third way is to select the comment button in the toolbar. The fourth way is to select the Insert tab in the toolbar and then select Comment from the drop-down menu. The fifth way is to select text or an image and then select the Comment History button in the toolbar, followed by the Comment button above the Comment History. And the sixth way is to press Ctrl-Alt-M on your keyboard. Note that if you use any of the methods that don't require you to select text or an image first, the comment will be attached to the word closest to your cursor. Next, we'll look at how to reply to comments. You can reply to other people's comments when you are sharing a Google Doc. If you're working alone, you can use the reply feature to remind yourself of additional information related to the main comment. To reply from the comment bubble, select the bubble and then enter your reply into the text box and select the reply button. To reply from the comment history, select the comment history button in the toolbar and then select reply in the comment. Once again, enter your reply in the text box and select the reply button. In the next section, we'll resolve comments. When you resolve a comment, you're telling other users or reminding yourself that the issue is closed. Resolved comments will still appear in the comment history, but they'll no longer appear in the right margin. To resolve a comment from the comment bubble, select the check mark. The comment will disappear from the right margin. To resolve a comment from the comment history, select the comment history button in the toolbar. Then select resolve in the comment. The resolved comment will remain visible, but will have a darkened background. If you change your mind, you can also select reopen to return the comment to its unresolved status. We'll look at how to delete comments in the next section. You can permanently delete your own comments, but you can't delete someone else's comment on a shared document. To delete from within the comment bubble, select the three-dot menu and then select Delete from the drop-down menu. A dialog box will appear asking if you want to delete the comment thread. If you're sure, select the Delete button. To delete a comment from the comment history, select the Comment History button and then select the menu arrow to the right of the timestamp, followed by Delete in the drop-down menu. Once again, select the Delete button in the dialog box asking if you're sure you want to delete the comment thread. The companion blog post for this video listing all the steps we just performed appears on erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic related to Google Docs, Microsoft Word, or Adobe Acrobat that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.